Yoho and welcome back to a new review for Mahotsukai no Yome, episode number 9. And in this episode we had quite a bit of comedy, but there was this huge demand on Chise's side. She wanted answers from Ilias. Because since they came back he was, well, holding himself up in that one room, and Chise was worried he wouldn't come out, and then she was kicked out by Silky to get a change of pace, and there she met Angelica, who was asking how she is feeling, and there they had a nice talk going on of, well, what Chise wants to do, what maybe about school, because she's so young, and then it came to the point that she may be well over dependent on Ilias, who bought her and the stuff, but the thing is, she kinda knows it based on her reaction. But she doesn't really know what to do else, so the thing is, she had quite the outburst of emotions. She was hitting the wall, but then apologizing, and there she was going like, well, yeah, she know that this is the fact, but she still doesn't know what to do else, and then she went the same evening into Ilias' room, and there we saw another form of him, which was basically like a huge snake lower body part and with his normal upper body, and there they were talking a bit and she was demanding answers for the next morning. And then when she woke up, she had the nightmare of her mother, and then, well, when she woke up, she found a note and Ilias was gone. So she went out, tried to find him, and then she came across the church, looked for him, nothing there, so she continued to search. There she came across a nice elderly man, was in the garden, and they started to talk, and there Ruth and Chise both saw it. There was another fairy. A vampire type of fairy who give that person something in exchange for blood. But the thing is, this vampire is a bit different. First of all, it was quite the fanservice-y version. So, yeah, okay. Give us that fan service we hadn't in the previous 8 episodes. Okay. Well, but all joking aside about the fan service, it was actually really sweet. How she was being a bit on the tsundere side, talking about him, and when he gave Chise a short story he wrote and she read it, he kinda was nodding off, and the fairy was on his lap, also leaning on him and sleeping. And at the end of the day, it was a love story from this garden, from his own garden. And by the end of it, he explained that, well, he met someone there, and it may be just an illusion, but yeah, and that one was the fairy, which is really, really sweet. And then how she saw him and how he was looking at her, because he saw her again. And yeah, this part, it was seriously sweet, and I really loved it. Super cute, super sweet scene, and it made me smile all the time. But when Chise left, she got a message from with that he found Ilias, that he was in the forest, and then she went to that small lake. There they were talking, and she was making that super worried face and being called out by Ruth earlier the day for, well, you're loving him, right? Because you're worried, and not only this and all the stuff, so yeah, why are you trying to, well, not be honest about it? So yeah, it was kind of strange and really liked it. So basically everyone is pointing into that direction, which is seriously entertaining. But when we had the talk with Ilias, and he was saying at the end that, well, give me some time so that I can gather my thoughts and then I will tell you. So yeah, and he was also commenting on Jess's worried face she made, so that this is the first time he saw her like this. So yeah, progress, ladies and gentlemen, progress. But yeah, all in all, once again, a wonderful episode, and I just loved it. So yeah, I think I will leave it at this for today. So as always, thanks for watching, and I hope I will see you guys next time as well. See ya!